Sorry to interrupt, but I had to come out here right this second. Because I've been waiting for this moment for a year. And you don't even know why. You can't know why, because you're Dwayne Johnson. You are Dwayne The Rock Johnson, the man conquered the WWE during the Attitude Era. The man left and conquered Hollywood. The man has returned to the WWE, conquered it again. Hell, you are the WWE Champion. You don't fail at anything in life, so you don't know what it feels like to tell the world, to tell the people you care about, that you have to do something and then fail. Last year at WrestleMania, I told every single person who would listen, especially those very close to me, that I needed that match, that I needed to win that match, and I failed. That moment, that match at WrestleMania wasn't just a loss to The Rock. That match, that moment sent my life into a tailspin. You don't believe me? Go back, check the timeline. Right after WrestleMania, you want to talk about something that sucked? It happened to me, both professionally and personally, because I could not get over my obsession with the fact that I failed. I couldn't jump over that hurdle with the fact that I told these people I was going to get it done, and I didn't. I get a chance to rewrite history. This is more than just a match for me. This is a shot at redemption. You realize how many people don't even get a first chance? I get a second chance. I have been gifted a second chance to right the biggest wrong of my life. So I just came out here to give you a 34-day heads up. I am not throwing this chance away.
As much as it matters to you, John, it matters so much more to me. When my music hits and I walk down that ramp and I step in this ring and I connect with every single person in this arena from top to bottom and all the way around and connect to everyone at home, every man, woman, and child, our connection, our bond, our strength, John Cena, it matters to me. So you get something straight right now. In 34 days at WrestleMania, you ain't getting redemption, Jack. You're getting your ass kicked.
Mike Tyson was once quoted for saying, "I'm gonna eat his children." It's sad we actually remember Mike Tyson for that, because Mike Tyson is responsible for one of the most powerful quotes I have ever heard. And every time I hear it, it reminds me of you. Tyson, in his prime, was once quoted as saying, "In order to be the greatest that ever lived, you have to beat everyone living." I have accomplished every single goal. I have jumped every roadblock in my entire career, except for you. At WrestleMania 29, your time is up. My time is now.
Your time is now. My time is up. No, 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 no. Rock's time is just getting started. You want to quote famous athletes? Well, I got a quote for you. I got a quote for you from a famous athlete, and it goes like this. Winning is about heart. You just got to have it in the right place. The man who said that quote, Lance Armstrong, he was full of crap, and so are you.
Unbelievable confidence, that confidence in your eyes. I had that a year ago. Listen, in 34 days, history will not repeat itself. I make history. In 34 days, at WrestleMania 29, I will become the WWE Champion.
You just crystallized everything that is The Rock and John Cena right here. I tell you in front of the world because we're live. John Cena, that's the biggest difference between you and me. You think you can beat me? I know I can beat you. And at WrestleMania 29 in front of the world, I will beat you again. If you smell what The Rock is